Hello everyone, my name is the Rad Man, and we are here for another episode of Farming Simulator 2017. I just thought I should show you guys where I've been dumping my wood chips because, let's see, there we go. Because I said I'd be cutting down some trees, and as you can see, I've been sticking to that. All I have left is these ones over here and those ones over there. And I have considered doing some other ones, because there are a few, like, by the barn and stuff that are kind of in the way. Like that one that we had to cut down when I ran into it with the bale wagon. So yeah, we might cut down those, but, like, look at how much more space there is, even with these few trees removed, like, except for this watering thing. This is basically free space. We can now go up along the side of that mountain as long as we don't do too steep of a route, since the rake would start having troubles if we'd go too steep. One cool thing that I'm guessing a lot of you have learned, but I thought I'd show you, is that if you overfill a trailer and you don't have this to dumping on the ground, then I know as long as you haven't like quit the game, this works. I don't know if this actually has an inventory that it can remember beyond, like, saving and coming back, though, because I know the bale wrapper, if you save the game and leave with a bale in the wrapper, it deletes the bale in the wrapper. But yeah, so we got a pretty good amount of wood chips. I think that was about 3-ish loads. I think it might have a ceiling on it, though, of how much this thing holds, because I put in quite a few logs, and I always get 5,000 out, so that's a bummer. I probably wasted about half of the trees that were here, but we'll save this now, just in case. And yeah, we are actually almost to the point where we're going to have enough of everything, but I'm going to get more of these, the soybeans, and then probably more canola, because those are the two things we're lowest on right now. That way I can spend the time while the harvest is being done. I can either spend that time cutting down trees or re-recording the new course. And one thing I've been thinking about doing is getting these two bigger mowers, because I figure, well, if we're redoing all the courses anyway, we already have the biggest tedder and, you know, windrower that we can get, so why don't we get the biggest swather? Of course, that does sell for only 12,000. We bought it for 17, so it would basically buy the front end of this, which means we need $49,000 to get this. And I'm not quite sure where to get it, because the problem is that if we wait and do a harvest with that mower, even if we do make a ton of money off the silage, the problem is that we'll be putting more wear and tear on that, so it'll be worth even less. So what I'm considering doing is selling a few loads of grain or something. I also wish that we could tell, like, when our silos were about to be full, because I don't know. Let's actually look. Like, so what if we go into placeables, and what if we just pretend we were gonna buy a large stud? Okay, so it doesn't even let you preview them. Okay, so that does make me wonder. I think that this is what we have, so I think in total that means our farm probably either holds 100,000 of each or 400,000 between all the silos. I'm not exactly sure. One thing I have thought about getting is this heating plant. Of course it is 68,000, but that would probably be put, I think I already cut this tree. If we did buy that, I'd probably put it like up there or something, because I think this general area is where most of the forestry is going to be done once we run out of trees down here to chop down. And the reason I'm getting rid of all the trees down here, by the way, is like course play and basically even workers have an easier time if there's no trees. And that's because the current course play workers are about as stupid as tar. And if there's no trees for them to hit into, that'll help a little bit. If you combine that with hopefully updating course play to not run into buildings with a collision mask, because right now the workers run straight into like my sheds and stuff. And yeah, we have a wood chips pile now, obviously. I said that already. And I'm thinking that this is going to be either potatoes or sugar beets, and this will be whatever one that one isn't. I am kind of disappointed, though, because it looks like you can't heap the piles very high. I was hoping, like, if you weren't careful, you could, like, heap it over accidentally and have it, like, spill out or something cool like that. But that's fine that it doesn't. Anyway. Okay, so now all of these trees are ready. And by the way, the best way I've found of doing this is coming around with the skid loader and bumping them off the stumps and then grinding the stumps and then just letting the tree fall on the skid loader. Because I've found that if you let them like hit the ground and they're vertically straight up and down, like I've had two trees so far, that one over on that hill, and the one, I had one over here by this rock, I had them, like, the other one had fallen over, and then it slowly started sinking into the ground, till all you could see was the top of it, and then it went away. So that does make me worry what's going to happen. If the trees are falling through the ground, I wonder how long it's going to be before something else falls through the ground. But hopefully that doesn't happen. And the other reason I want a better mower, by the way, is it'll go faster and we can do more ground with it. Plus, it's easier to use, and ease of access is one big thing when you're dealing with course play. Is the easier a course is to record, the faster you can get it up and running. And that tree is going to have to be removed stat, because it's even in the way of fertilizing. And if you're wondering what's going on right now, I'm basically just burning time from my plow tractor to finish. And the reason I haven't fertilized yet is it takes so little time that I'm just going to have the workers do it. But I'm going to use course play to line them up to show them where they need to start. And then I'll just hire a worker instead of starting course play, since course play calculates like exactly where it needs, where they need to be to do the most efficient job. I think I did all these. Yeah, okay, because as long as you can have your hand on them, that means that they're cut, even if they don't fall down, which is another helpful thing to know. So yeah, I'm probably after this guy gets done, I'm gonna have him take the mower to the shop, and then we'll sell it. Because with that money, we can for sure buy the front-end mower. And then, off-camera a little bit, I'll figure out how to do that, because... I guess I could show you guys a little bit of wood chipping, actually. It's not that interesting, but it is quite hilarious when the trees decide that that the way I think physics should work isn't good enough for them. So I guess let's try this. Okay, so yeah, just bump them off a little bit and then just lower it right down. And if you got lined up right, it should have started cutting it. Okay, and this thing is kind of weird, because sometimes you have to let the stump sit a minute for it to detect them, like right now. It's not even detecting that at all, so... I guess we'll turn this off, and I'll just have to come through. I think it'll help if I reload the save, but I'm not sure what's going to happen to the trees when I reload it, because... Oh, see! That's one of our biggest trees, and there it goes. Holy cow. See, that's why you don't hit them... That's why you don't do it straight, is they just do this... Oh, and I can't even cut it. That is weird. That is going to bug me so much if I can't make that finish falling through the ground. But yeah, that's one reason I usually bump it with the left side of it to make it tip. I don't know why I didn't do it with that one. Kind of stupid, but yeah, see if they tip, as long as they, it seems like if they don't hit the ground straight down, they'll be fine. And it, especially these really tall trees, like I almost wonder if it's the game trying to figure out, I almost wonder if it's the sheer weight of them confusing the game. Like this one, it should be fine since I caught it, but I'm pretty sure that it has something to do with the weight of them hitting the ground all at once, because I know that those trees, you have to break up their individual branches into really small pieces to pick them up by hand, which is how I've been doing this, because I find that if I go through and chop up all the wood at once, and then I just use that single tractor to take first the wood chopper, then the trailer, and if I just stagger like that, I can actually make pretty short work of these trees. But yeah, once this is done, I think I hear trees falling underneath us, and I think that those are the trees that I've knocked down. So that's three trees in this world. Let's try and keep track. Three trees so far have literally bit the dust. They're totally gone as far as the game's concerned. I hope they aren't going to cause lag, because I don't know if this game, like, I know most games destroy stuff that goes beyond the world border, but I don't know how Farming Simulator handles those type of things, because I've honestly, like, even in the last version of the game, I didn't have that happen. So this will be quite interesting to see what happens. There we go. So yeah, just shave them like this, and then what I usually do is I usually cut off the tips about here, because, yeah, if you cut off enough of them, like you saw, they disappear, and then sometimes they start doing the jig after you cut some of them off. And then I basically just keep cutting a little bit off until they quit disappearing. Because once they quit disappearing, that means that you can actually use this wood now, and the chipper isn't going to have a seizure. Because if you put in a lot of this wood that disappears once you cut it, it really confuses the wood chipper. Like, it hates getting anything of that. So I usually end up having to slice these down even smaller. But yeah, I'll go through and do this to the ends of every single one of them. This one is going to have to be shortened, so we'll try that. Okay, there we go. That should be small enough, because the smaller they are, the better they go through. And then these ones are relatively lightweight, but I do cut them to be a very small length, or at least smaller than I used to, because I used to leave these really long, and then I just had problems feeding them. And since I'm not hauling them very far, it is fine for me to just cut them up about this size. And we'll do that. Good, and then one more cut just because the bottom of the trunk is thick and heavy. So yeah, if we go along here, these all should be segmented so none of them are too heavy. Obviously too heavy because that one's not been segmented yet. Where'd I put the ends of those? I think I put them over here. And yeah, what I'll usually do is I'll usually stack these together. I think it's these two. Yeah, I'll stack all of the ends in one area. And then I'll chop these up first. And then I'll just slowly pick up section by section from the surrounding trees that I've chopped up. Like, I'll park the chopper here with the feeder here. And then I'll just slowly feed them like that. And with stuff that overhangs, I usually try and cut it as close to the hill as possible, but still not going over length, just because that can cause some pretty funny glitches. Though, of course, if you have a jumping log, you can't exactly saw it. And the reason I'm not using any of my fancy attachments I bought is they're pretty well junk. Just because they have some pretty funky rules for how they work, so I just decided not to mess with them. But yeah, so then I'll just come by one, pick it up, put it in, pick up the next one, put it in, and rinse and repeat. And now that I know that chopper definitely has an internal buffer of 5,000, I'm not going to feed it an entire tree if the trailer's not taking any, because I probably could have doubled this stack in the amount of wood that I've accidentally wasted by, especially if you feed it like these big tall trees. These guys are really, really heavy. Like, let's see. So I think if I cut a log this big, it's going to be too heavy to lift, because I know that these ones you have to cut really small. So let's find out. So this one, yeah, see, this length is too heavy, and that means that this is going to take a while to feed through the chopper, because it's a huge tree, like, they're so long. But yeah, I've wasted probably the equivalent of two or three of these full trees overfilling that chopper. But anyway, it's getting late, so I probably should, I'm probably only gonna chop up these trees, because I figure if they're chopped up and they glitch out, you know, if the pieces fly into the sky or something, I don't really care. Grimmy's on sale. We might look at that, actually. Let's see. Why is... What is Grimmy? Okay, it's just... Oh. I didn't realize Grimmy made the belts. Oh, it's only minus 5%. That's not that good. That's not that good. I would consider buying the potato thing. Not the potato thing. Oh yeah, Grimmy only makes potato things, basically. And this Vader Stott, which I think is from a message that I clicked through. Yeah, never mind. Well, that was a bust. I was hoping that... I was thinking of a different company. But yeah, like I was gonna say, I don't mind if these little chunks go flying when I reload the game. I don't want these entire trees going flying, though, so I'm probably going to leave that over there like it is, and then reload the game, and then tomorrow, when I have time, I'll finish this episode. But I think we're going to be done for the forestry for this episode. I think we'll resume when this grass has regrown, and I've somehow figured out how to earn... roughly 15,000, actually no, $20,000 is what I need, because it's, I think, 45-ish thousand, so yeah, we'll need to raise a little bit of money. I'm gonna have to move this though, so what I usually do is I usually pull that off to the side. I don't even bother folding this up, and then I just hook onto the back of it and drag it over to the next area. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna be right back after I get this done. I need to put that back a little. There we go. And yeah, then I'll just go get the trailer, stick it under there, and be right back. Oh, everyone. I'm back. So, oops, crap. As you can see, I've finished removing those trees. It only actually took me about 20 minutes. After the fact, so what we're going to be doing now is we're going to be maybe recording the a course to automatically sell the grain, though I need to look at the prices. Okay, so let's see. So Denton Bakery has a good price on wheat right now. Yeah, the price for sunflowers is really good, though we don't have many of them. Ooh, this is a great price for soybeans at the Maplefield Mill. Yeah, eventually we're gonna make a one to all these so we can take it there automatically. Right, agribusiness isn't that good for anything. So it looks like the prices have kind of stabilized. 556. Okay, so we're gonna slow down time again. Obviously those didn't grow that much, but I think now what we're going to do is we're going to sell soybeans to the Maplefield Mill and probably canola to the Denton Bakery. Wait a second. 1023. Oh, that's one. I thought that was 1018. I was like, how on earth is that better? So I think we're going to sell canola first, because this route is to a bakery, whereas the other route has to go to the train. and the Denton Bakery is down by the town, so that's actually good because we already have a few routes going over to the town. So this is going to be a grain transport route. I also heaped up all the wood chips, and I'm probably going to keep my forestry equipment more over where I put the wood chips. And I think I might consider buying that field if we make enough money, because it is ready to harvest, and we are going to need more soybeans after this since we're selling a lot of them. Because usually when a price is good, I like to sell everything of the commodity I'm selling. But we might just sell enough to make the mowers, or make the mowers, get the mowers. I did take the one mower up there already. That's one thing I did off camera. And yeah, it's the next day now. I'm not feeling real well though, so I don't know if I'm going to record more than one episode today. Okay, so I think the best thing to do is turn here, go through, and then loop back around. We might have to re-record this if we get a semi, because that's a pretty sharp turn. Okay, unload that. And obviously it won't unload right there, but it'll figure it out itself. Okay, so we now have enough for the mower. So we made 23,000 off that. Let's actually go this way. And that's just so if we have multiple trucks on one route, they will have less points where they could hit each other. Anyway. And this route would only be run after a harvest, so I don't think we'll have to worry about this getting hit like during harvesting or anything. So let's see, I can't remember how much we have left, but I think we should have at least one more load of it, and we should have on that field, it should be about 40,000. So I think by the time that we sell the soybeans, we should be good. Looking at that, I think that is soybeans, and I'm pretty sure I grew canola on my fields, all of them. It was either canola or soybeans, and we'll drive this over here because we do need it to line itself up, you know, decently well. That should be good, though. So this is, we'll call this Denton Bakery. Good. Okay, so now if we drive this course, it should automatically load it with canola, since that's what we were loading before. And as you can see, the price went down. No, it is loading it with wheat. Stop that. I think there's a setting for that, actually, if you're on this mode. Or there should be, at least. Okay, turning circle, no. Oh, there it is. Okay, so we're going to have it load canola. So let's go put this wheat back. I totally forgot that it gave you that setting. Okay, so that's Denton Bakery. I think, though, that since the price dropped, you know, when we sold that, I think we're going to take it to a different place now, though, because I'm not sure if we're going to keep selling our canola, because the price is now not green, and I would like it to be in the green range if we're going to sell it. So I think we'll take, I think we'll set up a course to take this over to the train, and then we'll drive one of the trains over to Maplefield Mill. So I think for that course, actually, since the train's over there, we'll have it start with the trailer being pulled through like this, and then we'll start recording over here. Okay, good, and then let's refill this real quick. We'll fill this with soybeans, which we don't actually have that much of. I don't even know if we have a full trailer of it, because I haven't harvested them in a while. Yep, we don't even have a full trailer of it, so we won't be running this course more than once. And since we're only going to be selling stuff not during a harvest, I'm fine with cutting across the fields because I'm not going to get like the, what are they called, four reel modules or whatever they're called. I'm not going to be getting any of those. In this route, I'm going to make it so that we can only run one at a time, just because this is a little bit cramped for space up here. But yeah, hopefully with this money we should get, I'm pretty sure where it's at 1300 at the Maplefield Mill, we should get enough money to where we can buy that field that's ready. And I'm pretty sure it's in soybeans. And let's set this here. Okay, press I. Do-do-do. And now all we have to do is go over to the train and take it over to the mill. But let's get this home first, because I'm not sure if... I know in the older version of course play you could get out of the tractors while it was recording the course, and it wouldn't mess it up, I'm pretty sure. But I don't know about it in this version, so we're not even going to push it. Because at this point, if we're trying to do things that were kind of working in the old version, we're basically just asking for the game to crash when the course runs. Okay. And since we're pulling in from that side, I think we'll go around the road and loop around. I'm afraid if we go through that machinery shed, then I'll end up parking like the combine or something in there and forgetting it's there, and then that'll cause problems. And the reason I like to set up these courses pretty early on is even if I do have to re-record them, you know, with a bigger, like the semis, if I have to re-record it with a semi-trailer, that's fine. Okay, two train. Okay. But yeah, the reason I'd like to like record these now is because especially when you're using smaller trailers, you end up having to make a lot more trips, and if you do it all manually it can take quite a while. Anyway, let's tab over to the train. So it's this train. Wrong train. There we go. So let's pull forward enough. I still can't wait to try forestry with these trains. So we don't have that much of it, but we do need to stop or we're going to end up with it in multiple cars. We'll just see. So yeah, I think it automatically goes to the one that you have in there the most of. And I was just checking to make sure I hadn't accidentally left something. And we can actually see now it's filling up both cars at once, so that definitely confirms that that's, you know, one big car. So I'm guessing this car holds the most capacity, and then I'd have to guess at least that that one with the lid on it probably holds the second most, and I'm guessing that the open car doesn't hold that much. Of course, that's just a guess, though. And it'll be exciting to see when we get to the day where we can actually fill up one of these trains to sell stuff. Anyway, there's a water tower. I wonder if that actually would work for filling up water or not. Anyway, we gotta start slowing down. That's one thing I still have not mastered about these trains is stopping them at the right place. Like, I'm terrible at it. Because it doesn't feel like we're going 28 miles per hour. This feels like a snail's pace. But of course the train takes forever to stop too. So that's something. Okay, there we go. Stop. Unload. And we'll leave this here. So we just made 22,000. So let's sell this. We'll sell that. Okay, so now we'll buy. We definitely have enough for both the mowers. I'm not sure about that other field, though, yet. So we'll buy this guy. I was like, okay, make sure I buy the Laylee, because buying Laylee. Okay, so we have 24,000 left over. So we can either sell something or just plan on buying that field the next time it's in soybeans, because the problem is, like I said, since the fields stay on what they were planted in by the AI, it does mean that you need to be careful not to buy like a sugar beet field if you don't have the harvester for it. But yeah, this is definitely going to speed up production. So let's load the farm to shop. No, shop to farm. That would have been a big mistake, because it would have been, whoops. Sheep and shop are too close together. Okay, drive. What on earth are you doing? You need to be in transfer. Okay. I was like, what on earth is it doing? I think it was trying to unfold the mower for some reason, but it wasn't. And I guess if that's going to be a problem, we'll just have to manually unfold them. Anyway, there we go. And that should be good to make its way all the way home now. Oh, yeah. I forgot. That's the second thing in the vehicle list. So, yeah, let's move out of the way a little bit, and let's look at the prices more. So we could sell some sunflowers. Obviously, we're not going to make much money because we don't have very many of them. But the price of canola is on the rise, so we could always... let's actually check and see what my relationship is with that guy. I think I have something sitting over there. Or not, really. I don't. Let's walk over there. Shouldn't take us very long. Because what we could do, I guess, is we could just... Let's see, what does he want? Okay, so 7,000. So even if we did harvest this for him, we still wouldn't have enough. But it is 39,000. So I think what I'm going to do is... do this mission. Oh, here comes our mower right on time. So yeah, I think what I'm going to do is do this mission, and then after that, probably do the fertilizing, and that should mean that if I do the cultivating, we'll definitely be all the way up with him, so that the next time it's in something that I actually need to harvest, like soybeans again, that means I'll be able to buy it. But anyway, we better stop this, because this tractor can actually drive pretty fast even with this on it, and I don't want to know what on earth it'll do if we just let it go. Anyway, let's unfold this and see. So we're not going to need like course play to calculate this or anything, but I'm hoping that it'll be able to figure out that, you know, it needs to do both of them. And like I said, if not, we'll just get it to start near. We'll have like the starting thing do like we had over there. And basically we can have it start like here. And then we can have it start at a waypoint here with it unfolded, and it should automatically figure it out from there. And you know, if it doesn't, it's not that big a deal. I mean, this is a huge upgrade from that thing that we were using before. Of course, do have to be... Wait a second. Okay, I was going to say, it looked almost for a second like you could hook the front thing on the back, but then that's a jack, not what I thought it was. But we do have to be a little careful when turning now, or we're going to miss more. But it was kind of the same with that other thing anyway. So I guess we'll just leave this here, because that's going to be one of the first things we need to do is record the course. And I might stick a different tractor on this, I might not, not really sure yet, because, oh, this guy's almost 10,000 to repair now. We're really putting the hours on him. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do then is I'm not going to make you guys watch me harvest soybeans for that guy, because we've already done that, or we've already done something. Oh, by the way, I had to bring the little skid loader over to fix that, because for some reason when I was dumping over here right next to this corner, I don't know if this isn't a solid wall at the bottom or what, but it basically just poured it all outside of this little bunker thing. But it looks like this side works fine, as with this side and this part of it. I don't know why this was just broken like that, but I fixed it. And yeah, I'll be right back. I'm gonna go harvest that real quick, and then we'll be right back after this regrows, because we're going to work on making our mowing courses. So I'll be right back. Hey everyone, I'm back. So I had to bring the skid loader down here to clean this up, because I started speeding up time again. And I also brought that tractor down so that we can, you know, give these guys water, because they were getting low. And I figured that I'd start recording, because in 3 hours and 21 minutes is when we get the new sheep. And yeah, those, all that stuff is definitely not going to be done. So I'm wondering, is it going to be a full-grown sheep, or is it actually going to be a little sheep? Just because it'll be interesting to see. And I'm wondering, could you get to the point where, like, within, like, 10 hours, if you had enough sheep, I wonder if there's a cap on how fast they can reproduce, or if you had, like, 50 of them, if they'd be, like, every day you'd get a new sheep. Also, I kind of really want to know what on earth is going on with this feeding trough, because it's down to 2,800, and it's still going strong, I guess. Anyway, in an hour and 42 minutes, so I think that means at midnight. Let's see. No, okay, so at about 1 o'clock in the morning is when that's going to happen. I was going to say, man, in real life, it would be nice to know when it's going to happen, because, I remember when my boss used to have milk cows. It'd be like, someone was that calf born. Oh, probably around 1 in the morning. Lucky it's alive, because no one was up to see it. So over a full day, we can pay for our animal upkeep and the interest on our loans and a little bit of the vehicle running costs. So we might consider investing in more beehives. Okay, so we should get one. 1, 2, 3. Oh, wait, I think I just saw one pop in over there. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8, 9, 10, 11. So I think that one is our 12th sheep. And I'm pretty sure that I saw it pop in. Let's see. So now we have 80 hours. And I know that we were at over 100 hours when we only had 11. So yeah, that it does increase, which is good. And I'm going to give them water. But I'm not going to give them water till I have to take the tractor back to the farm. That way they can last as long as they can. The good thing is, I guess, since water does cost so much, the sheep at least don't use it up very fast. I'm pretty sure cows drink like one cow, milk cows at least, can drink like 80 gallons of water a day, though. So I'm not sure how that's going to work with that little trailer. Though I'm guessing it's not realistic proportions, for obvious reasons. Anyway, let's get in. And then, yeah, I just thought I'd show you guys that. So I'll have to review it in post-production, but I'm pretty sure that sheep, either that one or that one, did just pop in at the end of that. So there's no, like, at least for these guys, there's no, like, growth period. I am wondering if that's going to be a thing with pigs, though, because I think pigs, that will be more important, because it said that that's the only way to make money from them, is to just sell them when they're older. So, but yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they did it. Obviously we don't quite have the capital to do it. Oh, one good thing though I found out is, I did make enough money before the, like, vehicle running costs were subtracted. We could have bought that field. The only problem is it would not have been seeded, and I do not like buying unseeded fields. So, I'm just going to wait up here, and then when these are ready, I'm going to start the combine, and then clean over there and give them water, and then bring that back over here. And we can actually slow down time, because we can actually do the mowing now, which is good. I need to use the bathroom though, so I'm gonna do a few things like go clean that, and then we'll come and I'll probably have to move that pallet, but we'll see, and then we'll start recording the new mowing course that will do the entire yard. It's gonna take a while, but it'll be worth it in the long run. So in the long haul, in the long run. So I'll be right back. Hello everyone, we are back. Sorry, I just had to move that a little. So I think that we are going to start our recording of our mowing course, so better get both these turned on. I already have them lowered and everything, and holy cow, does this guy go slow when they're both on. But I guess that should be expected, since it is taking a lot of horsepower to do this. Holy cow. Yeah, this course might be one that we are going to have a tractor that's going to be running for quite a while. Let's actually stop there. Let me look at the horsepower requirements for these. I didn't actually check them before. They should be, yeah, right next to each other. So this one needs 90. This one needs 170. We should have 170, shouldn't we? No. Oh! That is really interesting. It'll let you run it. It just decreases the speed a lot. I thought it wouldn't even let you run it. So I guess to make efficient use of these, we actually do need a bigger tractor. Which does throw a pretty big monkey wrench in the plans. I guess the next best thing to do would be to stick our slightly more powerful tractor on that we have sitting right there. The only problem is that those do not have a front attachment. A front three-point, that's what they're called, is three-points hookups. So let's see, that one needed 175, so I'm guessing that when we buy a baler tractor, that tractor is going to do double duty. And we decided we're going to get this one. I wonder how much the cow edition is. Okay, so it's the same. And yeah, it's looks like it's the same. Yeah. Anyway, we'll have to think about that more now. So I guess for now I could either just stick on the back mowers or just do a course that uses only the front mowers, or if I do end up just having it go really, really slowly, I'm definitely not going to show it all on camera. Let's see. This actually goes decently fast. The only problem with it is that, you know, it'll take a while, and I have to be a little more careful about not hitting stuff. Yeah, I guess I could just mow this all by hand, and then, because we should make a decent amount of money off this, because that produced about 7-ish bales. No, it produced 9 to 10. This will probably produce another 2 or 3. So we should make around 24,000 every time we harvest this. So I'm just doing quick math in my head if you're wondering what I'm doing. So I think that means that it would be worth it to... How much are our tractors worth? I'm like trying to think of easy ways to make money, because now you don't make very much off missions. So those are only worth 10,000-13,000. This is worth 17,000. But obviously, to make any good money, I'd have to repair them, which costs money, and it's like, oh my gosh. I guess another option is we could buy another beehive for $20,000. I still need to get a more powerful tractor to go and grab the fertilizer from the shop, though. Though I did bring, you know, that two of them home on the pallets. I did bring that home on the trailer. I'm just weighing my options right now. There's not really a lot of easy ways to make money at this point. The easiest is probably, you know, mowing and stuff. The problem is that even if I did just put that bigger mower on the back of this, I still don't have enough horsepower to run it at full speed like I am with this one. So that's probably not gonna happen. So I think what we'll do is I'll just keep cutting this like I am, and eventually we'll get a bigger tractor. I'm really trying to think. I mean, the problem is that to get that much money, I'd probably have to harvest like 2 or 3 hours worth. And where I'm not feeling well, that doesn't really sound appealing right now. I guess what we could do, though, is I'll finish this off camera. And then I'll start the harvest. And I'll set up all the other routes that I haven't yet for selling, you know, for selling our grain. And then what we could do is just wait for the next great demand, because all of our fields should be at full productivity, like the best possible productivity. So we'll just do, you know, 2 or 3 harvests in a row of the really expensive stuff like canola and soybeans. And then either hopefully a great demand will come along eventually. And even if it doesn't, we can still send it out somewhere with our automatic courses. But anyway, I'm gonna finish mowing this off camera because it'll take a while where I'm only using a front mower. I'm actually looking at this and I kind of wanna... Let's actually check real quick which one's bigger, because for 12,000, that's actually not a very bad width. Let's see, so... The one that we were using was 4 meters. This is 3.2. Which, considering that it's attached to the front of it, that's actually not that bad of a front mower. Sorry, I hope you guys couldn't hear that. I am getting sick, of course. It's not fun. Anyway, so yeah, what I'll do is instead of just cutting this area, because I was just going to cut in here, I'll probably just cut everywhere I can so that I can make most of my money off this hay. But then, you know, anything that I either can't cut or can't rake, I'll just leave. And then I'll be back after the harvest or after I've sold enough hay to buy the bigger tractor, because we're obviously going to have to wait one full cycle, because I'm not going to try cutting it if there's nothing here to cut, because I won't be able to tell where I've been and where I haven't. But once we get the more powerful tractor, we're definitely going to use what I've found from cutting, you know, these manually. We're going to use that to decide how much of it we're going to automate and how much is just not worth messing with. Like, I don't know if cutting around that rock is very worth it since the mower was bouncing up and down. But anyway, I shall be right back. And I think we should be at about a half hour. I'll probably check that too, because I'm thinking that I might make this episode a little short if I keep having to do off-camera stuff to earn money. But I'll be right back. Hello everyone, I am back. So, let's see, where was I? Oh, yeah. So I harvested all this. It took about an hour. And I got 2 or 3 loads of bales off it. and I figured out that we can actually check and see how much money we made in our finances, because that's the wrong one. Where's sold bales? Oh, today. Okay, so we made around 42,000 today off of those bales, because now we have 74,000. Obviously that's still nowhere near, you know, what we need to buy a new tractor. And ideally we need that 170,000. Ideally we would need about 270,000 actually, to replace this baler. Obviously we're going to keep this baler because, doing these in round bales works the best because of the bale wrapper. But besides that, that's about the only reason we'd keep this. And it's starting to get a few hours on it. These don't have very many hours on them. But yeah, we also need to replace one of these tractors. The only problem is that they only sell for like 10,000. Unless I repair them for 12,000, which I don't know how much that would up the value. Let's actually see which one of them, you know, is costing us more. So the combine is costing us almost 2,000 a day. The header for it is costing us $148 a day. And I'm guessing this is the selling price, maybe, if you take it to the shop, I'm guessing. So this is one of our tractors. This is the case. There's our other case, so they're pretty similar, about $100 difference. The New Holland is not quite as expensive, so the problem is, though, is that these little cases are more powerful than the New Holland, but we do have two of them, is the thing. So what I'm thinking of doing is saving the game and then seeing how putting $12,000 into this one would affect its price. So let's do that. That cost a bit of money. I mean, went from 75 or whatever we were at to 61. So now let's go into the garage. And also, I've been thinking about buying a leveler, because that way I could keep the wood chips pushed up in there. But anyway, let's see. So we have this guy is now worth $60,000. So we could get $120,000. We would have that if we sold it right now. I just want to make sure I didn't repair. Okay, so I didn't repair the one that can use the front loader. So this one, if we sold it, we actually wouldn't need it. It's just nice to have around. Like, we can operate the farm as is without this tractor, and it would sell for $60,000 right now. Which that would give us $120,000, which is still $50,000 to $60,000 short of this guy, which is a problem that we need to come, you know, we need to get over it. The other problem is, though, is that even doing this much hay, we still only made $50,000 off it, which is a lot of money. The problem is, though, is that it's infrequent enough that is mostly probably going to just help pay for the workers, honestly. Though, again, we don't have to pay for plowing this time, which is another thing that eats up a lot of money, is whenever we have to plow it, I think it cost me $4,000 in the worker for the plowing. So yeah, this is the thing to think about, is do we sell this guy, because our mower, the front mower can't even attach onto this, so we can't sell the New Holland, or else we have no mower. You have to have the bigger tractor to use the back mower anyway. Also need to upgrade this baler, but that's optional because we can continue using it as is, since we have at least two or three crops where we don't need a bigger baler. But preferably before the next hay harvest, I would like to be able to use that back plow, since this is a really slow thing to do if you only are using, did I say back plow? I meant back, back mower, because this was really slow to do with only a front mower. The good thing is, though, is that since we aren't doing any straw, that means that the bale that's already in here can be kept till the next harvest. So, yeah, that's just something to think about. Plus, we've already invested a bunch of money in stuff. So, I think what we're going to do is this guy is going to go over to the shop. I won't actually sell it, though, because I also remembered that we don't actually need, we only need basically three tractors to run this farm if, like, during this part of the harvest, because since we're not doing any straw, we only need the one tractor on the tipper over there, which is what this tractor's for. We also only need one tractor on the seeder, which is what the one with the loader is for, so we don't actually need specifically that other tractor right now, because really all it's been used for is speeding up the baling a little bit, but we're not doing that, so it's like, well, I don't know, it's hard to decide. Let's see, I think it's unload 3, yeah, unload 3. Okay, just getting this ready because we're about ready to start. It'll obviously still be a few minutes, but so yeah, I think what we're going to do is we're going to send this guy over to the shop, and we'll sell him. If we're going to sell him, we'll make sure that we sell him before, let's see, farm to shop, good. We'll sell him before the next time that we get charged, because we still are being charged for him if we own him. And there we go. I think I put this guy in the wrong mode. Yeah, he's in that mode. He needs to be in this mode. And I think we can just set him right here. And yeah, he'll sit there waiting for a combine. Obviously, I kind of wanted to move him for the tractor that's coming, though. That was why I moved it. And yeah. Because, like I said, this guy's kind of optional at this point. So I think it would do good to sell him. Because that'll be 120,000, and we needed, what, 170? So we need exactly $50,000 more, which we could get that. I'm trying to see if there's anything else we could sell that I don't need. There's not really. Because all this stuff we need, or it's just not that valuable. Because, like, we could refurbish this a little bit and sell it, but it's like, we need that still. And we'll probably always need it, because I don't know if I'll ever buy the one that has the crane attached to it, because it's the cranes on those are pretty pathetic, just to be honest. And yeah, since we're going to sell this guy, I think we'll just sell it right now. And then what we'll do is to get the extra 50,000. Let's actually see what the prices are like right now. So we don't have any good prices for any of these, and we don't have any great demands. Oh, except the right agribusiness. I totally forgot that I could sell it to this place because it's separated like that. We could sell to the right agribusiness. I also forgot to make the routes. I said I was going to do that, and then I just totally forgot because I'm under the weather, to say the least. So we're going to stop him, and we're going to make a route to go to the right agribusiness, which is, it's up there. Holy cow, that's quite the ways away. So I think the best course of action would be to, and if it's up in the left hand corner if you haven't seen it already. So I think the best thing to do to get up there would probably be just to follow the main road by that gas station. So we'll need to start the course here with the trailer under there, And we're going to fill it up while we're here because we may as well. So we're going to sell it some canola, which will make us money because it's canola. What does that do? I don't even know. Okie dokie. And once we're full, we'll go. Okay, so then what we're going to do is, since the yard is always full of stuff, we're going to come around like this. And I guess we'll close that, because why not? And, whoa, crap, I almost tipped over my water bottle. We're going to stop. We're going to take away those last few of those, and then we're going to unpause over here. And there we go. Okay, so that should be fine. Yeah, okay, that's basically just gonna... It's gonna make it a little bit weird, but it's not gonna break that by any means. I'm gonna lower that down a little because I realized I keep having it, like, right in front of my face, though the sound should be about equal, even if it's down a little. And yeah, I also did over there, about here's where I stopped, because it starts getting really hilly. And yeah, basically we'll just take the long way around, because I realized even if we did cut through our fields like we were going to the sheep farm, we'd still have to go all the way around because of the river, because that river cuts a giant channel through everything that makes it hard to get around. But yeah, I'm probably just going to drive up there. I'll just set the cruise control. Have it set to maximum, please. And yeah, I'll just drive up there and I'll see you guys up there. This is not a good sign. Okay, this is just the hill. Okay, I thought it was my tractor for a second. I was like, oh crap, don't tell me it's dying or something. But yeah, I'll be right back. Hey everyone, I'm back. So it was quite the drive up here because it's quite steep. Anyway, let's sell this. Okay, good, sell that. And, okay, I can get out and it looks like it didn't mess anything up. I'm just wondering, what on earth is this even for? Okay, I have my tooltips on. So, I don't know what that's for. We did make 22,000 though. Which is good. Anyway, let's see, what does this say? Okay, that didn't even bring up like a tooltip or anything. So I don't know what that's for. I don't know if that's like a place you can buy slurry or something. But anyway, I'm gonna drive this back. It'll be quite a drive, so I'll be right back. Hey guys, I'm back. So I actually was looking at my prices after I got back and saved the course to the right agribusiness, and Denton Bakery actually has the best price on these barley. These. So I'm gonna have this guy keep going. Oh crap, I forgot. Start at first waypoint. Okay, so basically now what he should do is he should figure it out. I'll help him turn around though. And yeah, now what I'm gonna have him do is I'll have it keep going on this course until there's no more barley left in, you know, in the silos. Stop, you flipping idiot. I guess I better fill him up with barley, because for some reason it's going without being full, which is a little bit of a problem. Or, oh, if we have it start at the nearest waypoint, yeah, it'll go from stop to, that's not right. So I think if we have it do that, yeah, it'll go through the stop sign and then it should stop and refill up at the start, unless that's totally glitched. Okay, and it's got barley. So, let's see, we have 50,000, we had around 50,000 of it, so that should be a few loads. Let's see, okay, so yeah, so I'll probably let it run the full three times that it should be able to. Of course, I'll have to tell it manually to go on the last load because it won't be able to get all the way full. But I'm hoping that selling the barley will give us enough money to actually get the tractor. Because while that did give us a bit of money, the problem is we just need more. Because these are just... that's the wrong one anyway. These are just so expensive is the problem. And I don't think I actually sold that tractor that we sent up to the... I didn't sell this one yet. Because I was like, we should have more money than that. So we're going to sell this one real quick so we get an accurate count of where we should be at. And we'll save the game just in case something happens, like maybe a great demand or something is like 5 seconds away. But let's sell this directly so we have 72,000 for the standard setup. I don't know if we'll get more than that for the other one where we've customized it. That'll be interesting to see when we eventually get rid of that one too. And anyway, let's see, how much money do we make? We only need 170,000 now. Come on. Okay, so we are really close. We just made 10,000, and if we'll make another 10,000, we'll be good, and we might not even need to sell the third load of barley. Anyway, I'm going to be back after that happens, and I'll probably show you guys buying that tractor. So I'll be right back. So for this episode, I accidentally recorded 2 hours of video instead of 1 hour. I'm recording this, of course, in post-production. So I'd just like to thank you guys for watching. So in the next episode after this, where on earth did I put it? Oh, back there. So this is going to be the end of this episode. I didn't intend it to be, but next episode we're going to get this guy. And that will be basically what happened was I recorded before lunch and then I recorded after lunch. And everything after lunch is this part. Everything before lunch is the part that you just watched. But anyway, so that'll just be split into a separate episode. I'm going to make a new intro for it and everything. So I'll see you guys in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.